I'm gonna share with you my 5 main tips when it comes to dressing like a boss and acting like a lady. Keep on watching, it's gonna be interesting as usual. You are gone, I just wanna be with you. Please don't get. Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue à mon canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yakusu. Today it's such an important moment for us women, and that video is something that I really wanted to do because it's been more and more seen and visible to have women being leaders, growing up businesses. And especially with the past couple of years, we've gone back to the 1980s vibe, or this styling fashion phase, a lot more trends towards that shoulder silhouette shape or more structured shape. You have a lot more versions of it, boss ladies, but to still keep it feminine. Therefore, you're gonna see a lot more puffer, shoulder silhouettes, a lot of things like that, more on the soft power. People are gonna feel my confidence. I don't need to scream, I don't need to be enraged. Love that soft, feminine side to it. The first thing I would say here is to go with a blazer. Probably some of you might have guessed it. Not because I'm wearing one, like at all. Going with a blazer for me is just the way to go. It's probably one of the first staples that I always have in my closet and that I always suggest women to have. Even if you're not big into blazers, having one of them, a punch to your outfit. What are you gonna do? Whichever occasion you're going to, having a blazer is gonna structure your outfit even more. Keeping it balanced because you can still keep it feminine. And a blazer for me is an intemporal. It has become intemporal. You can do so many things with it. You can wear it at any age. It's still possible to include a blazer in your lifestyle. That leads me to my second tip here, still related to blazer, of course. Consider wide shoulders. Have square shoulders. That's gonna be a little bit more trickier. Harmonious balance or harmonious shape. The wide shoulders to me get and have more attitude. I love my edginess, the way to kind of play with that androgynous side, much more bossy, mixing feminine and masculine. I'm loving it more and more. That's gonna make you feel like you're a boss, and that's gonna make you look like a boss. If you wear it with, let's say, a dress, for example, something much more feminine, that's where you are able to combine both of the best words. Still feel like a lady because you have a dress and have that kind of feminine silhouette about it, but still keep it structured. I'm a boss, I know what I'm doing, and that's it. Love what I'm saying in general. You already know that I'm not about just keeping it one way. I'm all about mixing matching. That's not only gonna give you an edge, but that's gonna give you a sharpness. It's the way to do it. It's just the best way to do it. To something a little bit more fun, personalize your suit. You don't have a choice, you have to wear a suit. There's a couple of options. Think bolder colors, red and blue. You don't have to make it all blue. You can still mix match because we're living in an age where you can take the most basic, the most simple piece and still make it look like you're the boss. Look at Michelle Obama. I love Michelle Obama. Like, she's not afraid to bring her own edgy style to her outfits, even when she knows that the whole world is literally looking at her. And she's confident enough to be able to bring it on without having to be scared of affecting people or just like shocking people. You can keep it ladylike, but you can go beyond whatever you see in the society. That brings me to my Michelle Obama that I love so much, and that brings me to my other tip, which is to go monotone. I'm not big on monochromatic. I think monochromatic is a good way of doing things, and be able to play with the monochromatic here is to be able to play with the textures. Have something neutral. You're keeping neutral, but you're keeping interesting enough by playing with the textures. If you have to wear, let's say, a tuxedo, for example, you have a blouse, but just a solid color, which could be really complimenting, and just keep it black as well. But because it's a different texture or just a silk, for example, not only do you have the sharpness, but you have the feminine because of the fabric, because of the silk. It's like lace, same thing goes with fabrics like velvet. Janelle Monáe for me represents that more formal for your day-to-day look or day-to-day life. Most of the time it's like black and white. It's not playing with a lot of floral, a lot of pop colors. You have to think that if you're a leader, the less prints you have,
the better it is. And it's less distracting as well. You have to talk to a whole group, a whole people that needs to listen to you, that needs to be able to be inspired by you. You need to keep it neutral. The camera, doing a live, doing a speaking engagement. You can play with hassle culture as well, but making it in a way where people are not gonna get too much distracted by everything you have on you. You can keep it polished, you can keep it classic, but play with the textures. Love and like what they're looking at, but love what they're listening to as well. Is to keep it sexy still. Sexy is still really feminine for a woman. Being sexy is not being tacky. Doesn't mean that you need to be inferior to a man. And one of the biggest misconceptions when it comes to being or acting like a boss lady, most of women tend to forget their sexual or sensual side. At the end of the day, even you being a boss doesn't mean that you have to act like a man. You have to act like you're the leader. Being a leader doesn't mean that you have to be like a man. Being a leader is being confident in yourself. People are gonna feel it much more than you trying to act up like a man. You have to go to an evening cocktail, for example, get a dress suit, blazer dress, for example, have heels, subtle enough to make it sexy without being tacky. When you know what you want to communicate, and it's all about the attitude. Having the attitude is to be, I know what I'm saying, I know what I'm talking about, yet I'm willing to listen to you as well. People are gonna respect you because you're gonna act a certain way, because you're gonna say certain things, and not necessarily because you're gonna scream more than anybody else in the room. Sometimes could be even better, just saying. Not necessarily better, but I think at the end of the day, our own weaknesses. And I'd rather go through my own strengths than to try to compare myself to a man. We're different, it's just the way it is. Some women might disagree with me. It's much more important to cultivate them. Summed up what I think about looking like a boss lady and dressed like a boss lady. I hope that was helpful for you. Only to celebrate woman empowerment, but we're still woman. Never forget that you're still a woman, ladies. And if this video was helpful for you, and you might wonder how you can dress up like a boss lady but still in a casual chic mood, stay tuned for my next video, because it's all gonna be about my birthday and what to wear for a birthday in general. Acting like you're grown up, because I think I'm a grown up, I think. Be able to not miss it, definitely subscribe, turn on the notification button, really making magic out of anything you already own and anything you need to add up to it. Think of it as salt and pepper. You don't need it if you don't have the fish or the meat before anything else. That's what my channel is about, not cooking, just styling, pretty much. And being, if you want to see anything else when it comes to inspiring videos or anything like that, chatty lookbooks, just get to see my last two videos dressing as far as this one, if that helped you. Check my handle on Instagram. The time being, I'm gonna see you next time for my next video. Muchas besos, a lot of kisses. Je vous vois pour ma prochaine video. Jenny, see you. Kisses, bye.